Hello everyone, let us continue learning C language. In our previous video, we discussed about how to use for loop, while loop and do while loop efficiently. And in this video, we are going to discuss about printing the patterns. And not only just printing the patterns, we are also going to derive a blueprint, a perfect blueprint, which will help you to decrypt any given pattern at ease. Let's get started. The first primary thing to know about patterns is what you print. Whatever we print is just some text on a 2D surface. And whatever we print on a 2D surface can be bounded by either a square shape or a rectangular shape. And most commonly, every single rectangle can be broken down to pieces of square. So in end, we are just printing a square structure in different orders. For example, the square structures are merely a matrix in terms of C language. And those matrix are always represented with rows and columns respectively. For example, to print a perfect matrix in C, matrix is always represented with rows and columns. So the vertical lines are represented with rows and the horizontal lines are represented with columns. And the row numbers, that is row identifiers, are represented with I as a variable, and column identifiers are represented with the variable of J in common. Even though these can be made replaced with any other variable, I and J are common variable names that are being used. So let's continue using the same. Let me assume a matrix of order 4. If there are 4 rows, the row identifier, that is I, starts from the value of 0, 1, 2, and 3, which means there are 4 rows which starts from 0 and goes on till n minus 1. Similarly, I'll also have columns, which is 4 columns, which starts from 0, 1, 2, and 3 columns, which again starts from 0 and goes on till n minus 1. So each and every element can be represented as a grid with corresponding row and column values. 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 2, 0, 3, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 0, 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 3, 0, 3, 1, 3, 2, 3, 3. So these are the elements inside a matrix, and these elements are identified with their corresponding row and column value represented as IJ format. And these are the elements which can be derived for every single position. This ideology is clear, I believe. Now let's think about, or let's talk about, how to print this exact matrix with the help of a C program. In order to begin, let's create a new file, and let me name this file as matrix.c in lowercase. And let me also open up a terminal to compile and execute and check our outputs. I'm beginning with the header file with a basic include of standard input output.h include, and I'm having a single main function, and within which I have a variable called n, which represents the order of the matrix. And I'm going to print a short message to the screen saying, printf, enter a number. So this will be printed to the screen while running the code. So this acts as a short interactive message to the user to prompt him what he has to do. And further, I'm having a scanf statement to read that number from the user, after which I'm going to have a nested for loop structure starting with the row value, inside which I have another for loop, which is J loop, which is your column identifier. Outside the J loop, I'm going to have a printf statement, which is printf new line, which is to print each rows separately and go to the new line for the very next row. Now, what are we supposed to do inside the J loop? What am I supposed to do in the nested for loop? Within which I'll just print each and every element in the format of I and J format with a space, comma I, comma J. So it prints I and J value and then prints a space. I'll compile this. Before that, I should include a return 0 statement. Now let's go ahead and compile this matrix file. GCC space, the regular GCC command, matrix.c-o, matrix is the file name, the output file name which I need. So I'm providing this matrix as the object file name. So the compilation is successful, as you could see here. I'm run this file with the name of matrix. Now this prompt me a message saying enter a number. So this time I'm going to give a number of 4. And this is exactly the same old matrix which we wrote on the notepad earlier. And you could see that is being generated with the help of a C program here. And I can run this file for different numbers of 5, 6, and so on. And that prints the matrix accordingly, the same structure which I wanted, a perfect square matrix. Now let us talk about converting the square matrix into the shapes we wanted. Whenever we talk about star patterns, the shape patterns, the patterns are mere slices out of the whole square. And whenever you talk about square, the square has 4 boundaries at present. The square has 4 boundaries at present. And the boundaries are the top boundary, the bottom boundary, the left boundary, and the right boundary. These are the 4 boundaries of the square. These boundaries can be identified with the identifier. The top boundary can be identified as I equal to 0. Bottom boundary can be identified as J is equal to 0. Left boundary can be identified as, the top boundary can be identified with I is equal to 0. The bottom boundary can be identified with I is equal to N minus 1. The left boundary can be identified with J is equal to 0. The right boundary can be identified with J is equal to N minus 1. These are the boundaries accordingly. Good. Now let's talk about printing these boundaries alone. Let's do it now. So I shouldn't print I and J value for all the places. Rather, I have some condition in place. So I'll have a if statement. Only if this condition is true, I'll print the I and J value. Else, I'll print something else. I'll just say printf. I'll later tell you what I should do or what I should print in the printf statement. Okay. Now let's talk about the condition first. Condition is the first important thing. I have to print only on the 4 boundaries. So all the 4 boundaries are connected with the OR condition, I equal to 0 or J equal to 0. It's only double equal to, or I equal to N minus 1 or J equal to N minus 1. So the 4 boundaries are good. Now what should I do in the else block? Else I have to print a space. Now remember, I'm giving only one space here. Now remember, I'm going to print only one space. And let's compile and check the output, whether it is a perfect boundary matrix are we printing here. I'm giving an input of 6. Now look at the output and tell me what is going wrong here. The rightmost boundary, right? The right boundary is not in place. It is supposed to be in this part. It should be on this line. Rather, it is printing somewhere the part which is not it's supposed to be printed. Now let us understand the reason why. Now this is the key element which I want people to concentrate and understand. This part, the space is not properly aligned, reason because of these two printf statements. These two printf statements does not print equal number of characters. Only in patterns, if you print equal number of characters, the pattern will be perfectly aligned. So to have equal number of characters, let's talk about, or let's count the number of characters we are printing here. In the first printf statement, that is on the number line number 9, we are printing 3 characters, you believe. That is I, J, and a space. Since we are printing 3 characters in the 9th line, we have to print 3 spaces in the 11th line. So that is 3 spaces. Now I'll compile one more time. I'll run it. Now I'll give the same note of 5 or 6. Now you could see the output is perfect. We have got a perfect square boundary matrix. Now remember, whenever you have multiple printf statements, the width of characters we are printing with the help of printf statements should be equal. If that is equal, then your pattern will also be a perfect pattern. Yes, pretty much good. Let's proceed for the next boundary, which is left out in the square matrix. Getting back to the matrix again, Now, these are the four boundaries we have talked about. And the remaining boundaries are, the yet another boundaries to be found out is a boundary which goes from left top to right bottom. And this is not just a boundary, it is called as a diagonal. This is basically a diagonal in square matrix. Now, let us take the square matrix again. The left topmost term is 0, 0. And the right bottommost term is 3, 3. When you connect these, the numbers along the line, when you connect the numbers along the line, what is the pattern you observe here? The pattern you observe among all the terms in these line, along these line, it is the numbers are equal. The numbers are equal. So here in our code, I will just change the condition. I'm not going to print along the boundary. Rather, I'm going to print along the single boundary, that is my diagonal boundary. So I'll say I equal to equal to j. I'm giving an input of 5. You could see it is printing along the diagonal alone. So we have our blueprint ready. This, my dear people, is the blueprint for patterns, which is for basic patterns. So this part, you just fill the condition, whatever you want, and that will print accordingly the pattern you need. Okay. Now let's talk about printing star along the line. Let's not print numbers. Let's talk about printing a star. Now, since there are only two characters in the ninth line, there should be only two spaces. I'll compile. The if statement can't be empty. I'll say I equal to equal to j. I'll compile again. Now I'll give a number of 6. It prints the diagonal for me. So diagonal is ready and printed. Yes, pretty good. Now the diagonal what we have spotted here has the formula of I equal to equal to j. As a formula of I equal to equal to j. What if I want the area above the line to be printed? Or what if I want the area below the line to be printed? In pattern matrix, it is always pretty straightforward. Above the line, it is lesser than equal to, and below the line, it is greater than equal to. I repeat, above the line is lesser than equal to, and below the line, it is greater than equal to. So here we are having two different conditions. The first condition is I less than equal to j, and the second condition is I greater than equal to j. Now let's go ahead. Now let's go ahead and see what these patterns, these conditions can do. I less than equal to j, I'm providing the first condition. I'll clear the whole screen. I'll compile. I'll run with an input of 5. It has printed above the line. Now let's give the condition as I greater than equal to j. Let's compile and run. Again, an input of 5, it is printing below the line. So with one small change of a condition, I can print two different patterns with the same code which I have. I can print two different patterns with the same code I have. So that is the reason why I called this particular code as a blueprint for star patterns. Okay. Now we have done with two star patterns. Let us extend it for a few more star patterns. And let us also talk about the remaining diagonal. There is one other diagonal we are yet to spot it. And that is I would mark with a different color. This line which goes from right top to left bottom. Let us spot the elements along this line. The elements along this line starts from 0, 3, goes on to 1, 2, 2, 1, and 3, 0. What is the similarity you see between the elements along this line, along this diagonal? Yeah, I and j are even, inversely proportional. When I increases, j decreases. Yes, good. And also, if you observe, the sum of I plus j is maintained as 3 throughout the line. The sum of I plus j is maintained as 3 along this line. And instead of 3, it is not just 3, it is n minus 1 because it changes for different order of matrix. So I'll call this as n minus 1 as you have it here. So the diagonal is nothing but I plus j equal to equal to n minus 1. So let us have that diagonal first. Let's spot it. So in our code, I'm going to give the condition of I plus J equal to N minus 1. I'll save, I'll clear the screen, compile, run with input of 5. It prints the diagonal perfectly for me. And it is still the same way with just like what we did earlier. Lesser than equal to prints above the line. So I'm giving it as lesser than equal to. I'll compile with 5. It prints above the line. And I'll give greater than equal to. Compile, run with the input of 5. It prints below the line. So you could see with one small change of conditions, the same old code which we used as blueprint still works for these conditions also. And the pattern is pretty much simple. We have got 4 different patterns with one simple code. And the conditions we used here are I plus J less than equal to N minus 1, I plus J greater than equal to N minus 1. And I'll quickly brief you through the shapes we have printed so far. We have printed this shape, the diagonal, above the diagonal, and the same thing below the diagonal as well. And we also spotted the other diagonal, which is above the diagonal and below the diagonal. We have spotted 4 different shapes so far. These 4 will act as the building blocks for any other shapes in future. And for this shape, the condition is, I would like to light in black. For this shape, the condition is I less than equal to J. For this shape, the condition is I greater than equal to J. For this shape, the condition is I plus J lesser than equal to N minus 1. For this shape, the condition is I plus J greater than equal to N minus 1. These are the 4 building block shapes for any shape patterns, any shape or star patterns, remember. And this is the blueprint which we will be using in future to print any star patterns. This is just the beginning of the patterns. It is just part 1 of it. In part 2 of patterns, we'll talk about how to join multiple star patterns and extract it as a bigger star pattern as output. And we will also talk about different types of joining the star patterns. Stay tuned.